to most people, a lake is a flat surface of water, and they don't think much about what's under that surface because they can't see it. It's almost like going to a different planet, and you've escaped because it's such a unique and beautiful environment. My interest in water really got started when I was a kid. As a family, we would go camping up in northern Ontario, and I would spend the whole vacation in the water, catching crayfish, and I just loved it. I just wanted to stay up there forever.
I got here 13 years ago.
Limnology is the study of inland waters. It's what we call a super science. We work with physics, we work with chemistry, microbiology.
This building is relatively old. It was originally built as a ceramic tile manufacturing plant.
The School of Freshwater Sciences is the largest academic institution on the Great Lakes. We're the only graduate school in the nation dedicated solely to freshwater.
What do the buoys do?
They've got meteorological equipment on the surface, measure weather conditions on the lake. The way we do research on these lakes is similar to the way research is done on oceans. This is the Niskay. This is our old workhorse.
Here in Milwaukee is one of the best places to do research on the Great Lakes. We're located right on the shores of Lake Michigan.
A lot of people who don't live in this area don't realize how huge they are, but they truly are inland seas.
Many lakes have had problems with the whole ecosystem.
Part of the challenge now is to figure out how will these lakes respond to these changes in climate.
One of the big problems appear to be due to invasive species, primarily zebra mussels and now the quagga mussels. You don't understand how valuable something is until you've lost it. We get huge benefits from the Great Lakes, so we need to conserve them.